episode 1660, as the day draws near.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive.
Happy, happy day. It is Sweet Spirit Sunday, a time of reflection. And for just a moment, I want you to slow down. I know for me, life has been moving very, very fast. So much is going on as the day draws near. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, when I go to write these episodes, I sit down and usually it's something that's on my heart or something that's happened over the last couple days or the past week. As you know, this is all real stuff. Most of these episodes are done just the day prior to. I don't plan them very far out because I want them to be real and raw. Now, obviously, I do have the archive, so you can always go back and listen to them on the website at createyournow.com or on all the different channels. Did you know we're on 11 channels? But as I sat here yesterday thinking about, Lord, what do you want me to say? Because this is a special time. Sweet Spirit, Soulful Sunday is a time really to what? To reflect. It's the vertical, the up and down, going to God, your relationship with Him. And unfortunately, I know for me, these past few weeks have been just on the go. Go and do, go and do, go and do. That's all I'm doing. But I don't always feel like I'm going and doing for God. As the day draws near, a heaviness holds your heart hostage. Something is missing, an emptiness needing to be filled. Give us this day our daily bread, the bread of life that sustains our heart. During this season, whether it's summertime, fall time, I mean, summer's crazy, right? Fall can be crazier too, and then you have winter, and then we branch into spring. We can come up with any and every excuse that I'm just so busy, and it keeps us, what, out of routine. We want to make changes in our life, but we can't seem to get into routine. There are so many more distractions keeping you from what's most important. Give us this day our daily bread. Can I just tell you? Can I just say I love bread? And I think how God's word is our daily bread. But when our day encompasses everything but His word, life seems to go downhill. We're not getting that daily bread, and it's not about the food. He wants to provide us a sustenance of life that is eternal. And it doesn't come from what we fuel our body with. It comes from what we fuel our spirit with. Give us this day our daily bread. I must say that as I write these notes down and outline, sometimes I write everything out word for word. Other times I just fly by the seat of my pants because I love to talk to you. You're my family. You're my sister. You're my friend. And during these short few minutes, I just want that time to be precious. I want it to be life to you, life-giving. I want it to serve something. I want to keep it simple because this is real living. I get up every single morning and have to brush my teeth. I go to the bathroom. I'm not some amazing person. I'm living life just like you, real and raw. It's as authentic as you can get. And as I was sitting down, trying to figure out, wrestling with what to tell you, this just kept coming to me. Give us this day our daily bread. I know for me over the last few weeks, I have just been going and doing, like I said earlier. And at times, I felt like, honestly, I mean, if I'm going to be honest, that I was living my life, but leaving God behind. And maybe those were just brief moments, but I'm not one who likes to do that. I mean, come on. I sit here and work out with God. I call him dude sometimes, like, come on, dude, pick up this weight because I can't do it. And yet I get so busy. Oh, we got to go to the pool, or, oh, I got to move my daughter and my son and get them taken care of. Oh, I've got wedding, you know, reservations and stuff I have to do and all this jazz. I just sit there and I go, oh my gosh, where am I leaving space for God? Am I? How are you staying connected to God? Are you talking to him daily? Does he hear your voice? A lot of people will ask the question and ponder, how do you know if God's talking to me? How do you know if he's talking to you? And that is a hard question to answer because it's very personal. It's hard to explain what God sounds like because God sounds like someone different to me, or how he responds to me than how he responds to you. But you don't know that response unless if you're talking with them. If you're really close to someone, whether it be your mom, your sister, your best friend, think about it, maybe me, that would be awesome. But just think about, bring them to your mind. Do you talk to God like you talk to them? Now, if you talk to God better than you talk to them, awesome. But most of us are talking to our best friend or our mom, someone very close to us, more so than we talk to God. God wants to be with us daily. Are you allowing him to be present in your day? He wants to be present in the little stuff and the big stuff. He doesn't want you to wait until there's a crisis. Because guess what? There's always a crisis, right? We're sinners. We mess up all the time, every day. So we should be crying out to him. But we get so trapped in our own stuff that we leave him behind. And I don't honestly think we mean to, but we forget what it's like to have a conversation with God. I'm kind of weird like that. I have a conversation with him in the shower, when I work out, when I'm running, when I'm walking, when I'm swimming, when I'm driving. Basically, whenever I'm calling on God, and it doesn't have to be necessarily a long conversation. Now, some of them are like forever, and I'm sure he's like, Christiane, I've got other things to do. Come on, can we speed this up a little bit? And other times it's like, man, it's so short that I'm like, did God even get what I said? I don't even know that I got what I said. Give us this day our daily bread. I love bread, and it's the bread of life. What God gives me. And I only feel full when his love has my heart. Does God's love have your heart? Is he tugging on it? Are you opening yourself up to hear him? Are you diving in? Even if it's just grabbing a Bible verse, one Bible verse. And if you're like, Christiane, I don't have time hardly to open up my Bible. Great. Grab one and focus on one for an entire week, an entire month, whatever it is. But get in the Word. It's your daily bread. It's your bread of life. I'm guilty as charged. I honestly would love to be in the Word more often than I am. But I feel like my mom responsibilities get in the way. My wedding planner responsibilities get in the way. My, oh my gosh, we're going back to school is getting in the way. Oh wait, then I have the business that gets in the way. Not that I'm saying that you get in the way. I have my husband that gets in the way always. I love him to death. But husbands get in the way. But we can put all this stuff together and it just becomes excuses. And so I want to challenge you this week to love the bread that God gives. One verse. And if nothing else, start with this one. Give us this day our daily bread. And pray it like this. Dear Lord, give me today your words, your bread of life. Lord, I don't know what the next minute or moment will bring, but I want you to walk with me. I want you to give me the words to speak love to the strangers I meet. Lord, I want you to open doors of opportunity for me to show and extend your grace. Lord, give me this day my daily bread. Fill my heart with your love. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. That is my prayer for you. Go out today. Fuel your heart with the daily bread that only God can give, the eternal bread of life. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.